go. Are we on?
We're on.
Hi, I'm Paul Brodie, and this is my shop. Welcome. In these uncertain times, I thought that I would show you what goes on in my shop. We've got a Gatorblade fork here. This was made back a long time ago in the 80s, and it's got U-brake bosses on it. And the owner of the fork wants the candy bosses. So we're going from obsolete to obsolete because everybody's got a disc brake now, it seems. So the first step is to get the bosses off. What I'm gonna do is to scrape off some paint, because when I start to put heat on here, when there's paint, I can't see what's going on. So I need to do a little scraping. It's actually a little hard to scrape off because it's powder coat, and powder coat is harder than wet paint. So I'll just do a little scraping here. Now, as I recall, on these brake bosses, these are silver soldered on. So that means that it's kind of a low heat. So they should come off pretty easy. We'll find out. Okay, that looks pretty good. I have paper towels, I have water. What I want to do is to stop a lot of heat going into the crown, because I got to put heat on the bosses and melt them off. So what I'm going to do is to take a paper towel and put it on the crown. I'll take some water, and I'll make it wet, because this will act a little bit like a heat sink on the crown, because I don't want any unnecessary heat going into the crown, because it'll affect the heat treating. Get my neutral flame happening. So what I want to do here on the boss is to put most of the heat onto the boss, because I don't want to put any extra heat onto the tube. You see how I'm heating away from the crown of the fork. On the flame, it's pretty bright, it's kind of green. That's because of the flux that's coming through the flame. It's part of my automatic fluxer. So if I'm silver soldering or I'm brazing, I've got flux on there. There you go. Okay, this is the fixture which holds the brazons, and these are the new cantilever bosses. Those go in there like that. Not sure if I got the right one on the right side. And that's the dummy axle. It holds the fixture in place. So what happens is, this is holding these the brake bosses at the right distance off the axle, because the rim is a certain size. If you get the brake bosses wrong, then your brakes don't work. So I'm just making a couple marks so I know where to scrape and sand. And it's the same thing again. I'm gonna put my gloves on because this has got some sharp edges to it. What I'm doing is I'm filing off what's left of the silver solder. There's not much, but I just want to take it down. So that didn't take a whole long time, and you can see how all the silver solder's gone. It's nice and smooth. It just needs sanding now. I haven't touched the crown. It's good. Emery cloth, inch wide, 80 grit. That's what I like. So what I'm doing now is a cross hatch. I'm sanding one way and then I'm sanding the other way. So I'm getting a cross hatch like that. And then as you braze over top of that, on a microscopic level, it's all uneven, although to the finger it's smooth. That's what the braze likes to grab onto. Okay, I'm happy with that. Here in the box is the cantilever brazons. They don't get used much anymore, but some customers still want them. So you have to have a certain amount of offset on these forks so that you get the spacing right. And the spacing from center to center, 75 millimeters. If it's too wide, the brakes fall down. If it's too narrow, the brakes are still coming up. It's important to get the spacing right. Let's go to the mill. I want to tell you that it's an inch hole saw because the size of the fork blade is an inch, and I've offset it a certain amount. That's the 545 thou it's offset. So when I go to do the other side, I have to offset it 545 thou the other side. So that's one side done. I also want you to notice that on the hole saw here, it's at an angle of 7 degrees because that is the angle of the fork blade that comes off of the steer tube. So I take out this and now I put it the other side like this. That's my zero right there. And now I'm gonna go 545 thou the other side. Also notice, Mitch, you don't have any safety glasses on. Whatever happened to safety third, hey? Speaking of safety third, what's first and second? Looking good, going fast. Safety third. So there's your bosses, and they've been mitered. You can see how they're at an angle of 7 degrees. And so what we need to do now is to take off the burr. I have a few little burrs on the inside. I don't know if you can see that, a few little burrs. So I'll take this little round file. I have a fixture here and this holds the candy bosses in place. And what I want to do is to check to see that I get everything right. So if I move it a little bit, if I give it a little bit of wiggle, I can check and see how the bosses fit. And it looks like they fit pretty good. I can't see any extra gaps around here. So I say we're basically good to go. So what I'll do is I'll put a little bit of flux on there now. You don't need a whole lot. It just wants to cover it. What the flux does, it protects the metal a little bit. And it also helps the braze. In this case, I'm going to use nickel silver. Nickel silver is a little bit stronger than the bronze, and it helps it to flow. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to put a tack at the bottom on one side, and then I will nickel silver the other side. If I just start brazing one side, sometimes what happens is the fixture is going to lift up, and then your bosses aren't lined up anymore. Adding some oxygen. If you can hear that now, there's a hiss. That's an indication that it's a little bit too big. So I'm closing down the oxygen and I'm gonna try that. I'm gonna tack one side so it doesn't move. Raise up when I do the other side. And there we go, it's tacked. Part of being a fussy frame builder, which is a hashtag I invented, I might say. Okay, so one side's done. We'll go back to the first side that I tacked. and that's it. So when I pull off the jig, they're on. I'm gonna show you here how to align a fork. I made all these fixtures. Well, I didn't make the campy tools, but I made other things, lots of holes. This is back in 85 when every frame builder was making forks. What this one does, it shows you how the fork is aligned as compared with the steer tube. So the axle is 100 millimeters, so the spacing needs to be 101 millimeters. It's an extra millimeter so that it always slides over the axle. If I measure this, you can see that it's 98.5. So I need to pull this out a couple millimeters. And this was designed so that this shelf is at the right height and I can put my knee here and then I can give it a little bit of force. And I just want to pull it a little bit. Aligning a frame with a fork, this is what I used to tell my class, it's the two F's. It's force and finesse. And maybe it seems like they don't go hand in hand, but you need force to pull, but you need a little bit of finesse, or a lot of finesse as well, because you pull a little bit, and if it doesn't go where you want, you add 10%. You don't add 50%, that's not right. Well, we're at 100.3. I don't want to pull more than that, so I'm going to say that's good. So that's the first stage of alignment, in getting the fork so that on the dropouts, they are equidistant from the center line. And what I've got here is just a piece of alloy. Put that on the fork blades. You eyeball from this level to here. And that tells you if the forks have any sort of a twist. Okay, so this side is a little bit higher. So I can either pull the right side back or pull the left side forward. So maybe I'll do a little bit of both. So I'm coming back on this one, just a little bit, and then I'm going forward on this one. Just a little bit. Okay, well, I'm gonna call that good. Now what we have to make sure is that each leg is the same distance from the crown. So that's what this fixture does. You put it in here, and it's a little wider than 100 millimeters. You see how it's equidistant on each side? And then if you want to double check the fixture, you take this off and you put it on the other way. This is how you know if your fixture is good. And the fixture is good because it's right in the middle. So that fork is basically aligned. Thanks for watching. I appreciate that. Maybe you'll want more.